Sergei is a conscript who's completing his last few months of the Soviet army conscription. He simply can't wait to get out of the army, but then basically when a fighter pilot turns up, it kind of bowls him over and they embark on an illicit love affair. As it's based on a true story set in the Soviet Union at the height of the Cold War, and of such a intensive type of a relationship and an exploring of friendship and something more, for me it was really, really amazing to get so deep into a character and be able to get so deep into a story. So I'm a writer on the film as well as one of the actors, and to be able to bring a story to screen which is about a type of love affair which almost seemed impossible actually in the Soviet Union at the time has been like a real joy, and I think it's a cinematic background which audiences haven't really seen before. Going to Russia, getting to meet the real Sergei, whose memoir the film is based on, that was just like an incredible way to be able to immerse really into not just a story but into a character. It was less of advice, more about like almost how he was and who he was. He was an amazingly courageous man, like amazingly brave, and also like just really sunny, really light, and that actually was really reassuring for me actually when coming to play the character, because it wasn't sort of like really ultra heavy, but actually just kind of going, okay, I'm gonna kind of go after love and dare to go after love, particularly in an environment which is so dangerous.
The film, like you say, is centered around a very specific time and cultural environment. What do you think more universally, though, this story has to say to people watching this here, America, around the world today?
Well, obviously in light of everything that's going on in Ukraine as well, my co-star being like actually stuck in Ukraine, not able to come, it's a kind of little bit of a sort of microcosm for a macrocosm, you know, like a traditional family values has been something which, you know, has been pushed for a long time, which is not acceptable anymore in terms of like modern day human rights. And I think that really, you know, I really trust that the film will be able to reach out to people and be able to give them like more courage, more hope, and to be able to like live authentically and see an example of a relationship where people went against all the odds to be together.
For you, was there one particular moment on set or one particular moment on screen that really encapsulates the spirit, that message of the film?
Honestly, I think it's like the New Year's Eve scene where in some ways it's a bit like I love you and it's also like goodbye.
And obviously Oleg very sadly cannot be with us tonight, but can you talk a little bit about your experience working with him and the astonishing talent that he is?
Well, yeah, he really is an astonishing talent in the sense of being able to actually, he barely spoke English when we first met, but he had the quality of Roman, and so he kind of jumped all feet in to learn English and also to be able to, you know, really dive into the role. And, you know, a lot of our chemistry came from actually like our physical interactions, because the level of our conversation was obviously not able to be that significant because I didn't speak that much Russian, he didn't speak that much English. So it was all about a lot of trust. Well, I think when, you know, having, let's say, representation on a screen, for example, that's been something that we've got a lot of compliments and a lot of gratitude about, is actually seeing like a true love affair actually to such scale as well has been really impactful for people. It kind of allows people to maybe even give themselves some forgiveness or a bit more of a break. I mean, some people have written to me saying like watching the film has been a bit like receiving a big hug, which I honestly find like really heartwarming. They some people also written saying that, you know, they'll treat people in the LGBTQIA plus community with a much greater respect as a result of seeing the film.
What's next for you?
Honestly, I'm really interested to play, I'm like very role driven, I'm really interested to play sort of like action type spy thriller stories. I certainly wouldn't say no to something like a Marvel, but you know, also I really also love like very strong human drama stories which are about overcoming significant challenges, whether that be like sports related or health related, and really like telling more stories which are about spreading compassion, hope and love.